Funko finds at a flea market? So this past weekend, I was able to wake up super early and get out to one of my favorite local flea markets. And let me tell you, it did not disappoint. There were a ton of different vendors out there selling all different Funko products, pops, sodas, even Wacky Wobblers, you name it, they had it. So I'm going to take you along and show you exactly what I was able to find and what I was able to pick up at the end. So this first table we stopped actually had some solid pops like this Ghost Riley from Call of Duty, but unfortunately the box was destroyed. So I wasn't able to pick that one up today, but you can see he had some a lot of older pops like the OG Freddy Krueger and Jason. Those did not have the blue barcode, so they were the older ones. He had some older Ant-Man, the Agrisecco from Barnes & Noble and Olaf Barnes & Noble. Vic's box here was all $5. He had a couple Starlights from The Boys, which were always good, some Ant-Man pops, some older Simpsons, and then like a dollar bin at the bottom. Nothing really of note in there, but just a solid table here with some much older pops. You know, for our first table at the booth, definitely not a bad one. And the next table had like a couple pops that you could see. Had that Jack Torrance Chase, the Flocked Sam from Spirit Halloween, a Sam out of box, the Blacklight Killer Clowns, and our first soda of the day, which also happens to be Sam. So just a bunch of mishmash of toys at this table, and he had a couple cheaper, more common pops over here. They were like $5. So, you know, solid table for number two, but we're going to keep moving on. And the next booth we came across is probably one of the bigger ones we were going to come to for the day. He had a ton of out-of-box pops to start. You can see that Ninja Stanley, the mascots from Camp Fun Days, Frankenstein, Strawberry Shortcake, just so many different out-of-box pops to choose from here. But moving on from out-of-box pops, he also had a ton of Funko sodas. He had Commons, Chasey's, just a whole bunch of sodas to choose from as well, right on the table next to it. But now we get into the pops that he had at his booth, and he had a ton. So many different pops. You can see all those different Conan O'Brien, some Toy Story pops, a couple Simpsons, Epting from Doctor Who, a Flash pop. Over here he had Dale from Chippendale, a Meowth, this giant Patrick Mahomes. He said it was water damaged, but just in time for football season. That's a great pickup, especially if you're going to go out of box. He has that Martian Manhunter, Spike Lee. What else do we have at this booth? A Jim Halpert, Arya Stark, Ryu, this Thanos, a Zeus from Hercules, and then a sports section, which was very well represented. I love this John McEnroe, the tennis pop, one of my favorites. He had pretty much everything from every sport you can think of. Hockey, football, baseball, everything. Wrestling. He had the posters, this Jalen Hurts that just came out from Fanatics, a giant Magic Johnson. And then over here is the anime section, which mostly consisted of My Hero and Dragon Ball Z. Had a couple One Piece mixed in and some My Hero as well. Over here, he has a Disney section with those new Stitch pops. He had some Marvel mixed in as well. I love this Fred Flintstone with the water buffalo hat. That's one of my favorite pops of all time. A couple FNAF pops. You got a Twisted Bonnie and also this cupcake here. Which you don't really see too often. It's an older FNAF pop, so definitely a nice one to see. He has a Gossamer up there, a Hoppy the Hopperoo, also from the Flintstones line, a couple Sopranos pops. Moving on over, you see that Sully and some Game of Thrones. And he also had some autograph pops, which I thought was interesting to see at a flea market. You don't really see that often, but a couple different autos, and they all had authentication. This signed Ellie and E.T., signed Jar Jar, signed Michael Myers back there, just a ton of different autographs. He also had this Con sticker Darth Maul. I love this pop. I actually love how clean that Con sticker looks too. One of my favorites for that year. Coming back, he's got this 3-pack Disney and the 4-pack One Piece. And this next booth had one of the more interesting things I've seen, this 3-pack of Pocket Pops Horror with Ghostface, Billy from Saw, and Chucky. I actually did pick this one up because I haven't seen this one in person in a while. He also had a Ghostface, but unfortunately this one was a fake and not a good fake either. He knew it was fake, so that was good. He wasn't trying to pass it off as a real pop. But unfortunately, you do run into some fakes out at these flea markets. But this 3-pack, I definitely had to pick that up. And speaking of fakes, look at these. You see these all the time at the flea market. This fake 4-pack of Lilo and Stitch. These fake Hello Kitty pops. Fake Pokemon. The packaging on these is so bad, but it's so good. You definitely see these all the time. This next booth definitely caught me off guard for a flea market. You can see he had those jumbo sodas, a couple Fright Night sodas from that New York Comic Con Fright Night at the Javits Center a couple years ago. But right next to it, you need to see what he had. He had some heat. He had a signed Armored Chopper, a signed Steve from Blue's Clues, a signed Goku, and then this Fire Nation Aang and Freddy Funko from the Avatar set. Crazy to see out here. This next booth had some older fun stuff as well. Like, if that Batman Beyond shirt wasn't a small, I would definitely be taking that home. He's got this OG life-size Groot from Target. He has a Punisher pop, which is a good pickup now with the Daredevil series coming out. A couple Disney pops, Jack Skellington there, and Merida. The shared sticker, Ducky from Toy Story, a couple Captain Hooks, a Bambi, Lilo and Stitch, and this giant 18-inch Pikachu. I always love seeing that. I have that in my collection. He had some more common-ish pops here, including this really cute Chef Snoopy from Box Lunch, a Hannibal, Black Panther, some Venomized pops, just a huge selection to choose from. All different prices, but mostly, you know, around the retail price. I think I pulled out a deceased Batman here from GameStop. Not a bad one, but definitely a large selection here at this booth. And now we're down to our last two booths of the day, starting with this one. He definitely had a large selection of pops, all ranging different prices, but all different genres of pops. You can see those Fry Guys from McDonald's. Over here, he had a couple Disney pops, some anime. He had this Winnie the Pooh, the Diamond Hot Topic version that came out earlier this year. Also, the Make-A-Wish one. Coming over here, you can see he's got some more anime stuff, some Dragon Ball. Looks like Jalen Hurts from Fanatics as well, Santa Stitch, this Skiing Freddy, love to see that one, love to see any sort of Freddy's out when I'm at shows or flea markets, so definitely love seeing that. Coming over here, you see he's got a John Lennon, a Charizard, SpongeBob, Mr. Potato Head, an Ursula Pop. Over here he's got some Bigs, that big Baymax, a Blacklight Michael Myers, a John Wick here. I love the John Wick pops. I think these should be going for more money than they are. Definitely an undervalued pop. The Duffer Brothers and the Upside Down. Coming over here, he's got that Blacklight Miles Morales and the original Ryan Reynolds Deadpool here. I think that is a pop that is slept on and will go up in value over time as Deadpool gets more and more popular. He's got this Thomas Wayne. Over here, what else does he have? Just a ton of pops to choose from. He's got that toucan, which would have been great for this year's Fun Days theme. It's that toucan dressed as a pirate. A Pikachu, another Santa Stitch, a Shaggy. Love seeing Scooby-Doo pops. Coming over, he's got more Deadpool, some Hamilton, another SpongeBob. This looks like the new dude from The Big Lebowski that came out last year during like the Fun on the Run, Cruella DeVille. Couple office pops, the Scranton Strangler Dwight, the Florida Stanley there. And then the booth, literally like two tables down, was our last stop of the day. And you can see they had a decent selection of pops too. A Dean and Crowley from Supernatural, a Viserys from House of the Dragon, a couple Stranger Things pops here, that Blacklight Eddie, the EE exclusive, a couple Wizard of Oz, love the way those look, especially the Wicked Witch. I love the new one that just came out of SDCC, a couple Star Wars pops, a Cobb Vanth, some Oogie Boogie, Jack Skellington again, more Stitch, a Flower from the Disney collection, a couple of the Seven Dwarves, some Beetlejuice pops, which are going to be gaining some popularity the closer the movie is to coming out, some Garfield, some One Piece here. You see that Funko Shop exclusive Carrot and Mikasa. Homelander, love seeing the boys pop, especially Homelander, and that one can never stay in stock. An Omni-Man from Invincible, Daryl Dixon, another Jalen Hurts Fanatics, Mike Trout, a couple chases here of Cowardly Lion and Vision 50s, a sports section and a music section here. some Pokemon, just a lot of pops over here at this booth also. Just a ton of pops to choose from these last two booths overall. And, you know, it's really great to see this large of a selection. They were definitely crowded. It was hard to maneuver, but definitely great to see this many pops and this large of a selection out at just a flea market in the middle of New Jersey. Definitely love coming out here and will keep coming out. All right, so as you can see, definitely a solid morning out at the flea market. I always try and get there super early, try and get the best deals, be the first ones at the tables, so I really don't miss out on anything that people put out. But I was able to show you everything I was able to find out there, but I didn't show you the three things I was able to pick up, so that's what I'm gonna do right now. So the first pop I was able to pick up from the Call of Duty line is this all ghillied up from that famous Modern Warfare mission. Definitely love the Call of Duty line. Did not have this one. It's got a little bit of sticker residue, some dings and dents, but you know, I expect that when I'm buying pops at flea market. But definitely really glad I was able to add this one to the collection. The next one, also from the Call of Duty line, is the GameStop exclusive, the Monkey Bomb, the regular Monkey Bomb here. I have the Toasted Monkey Bomb and now the regular Monkey Bomb. So two great pops. And last but not least, we have another Call of Duty, and that is the GameStop exclusive Frank Woods. So I was able to get all three of these from the same vendor, the guy that had that one Ghost with the damage box. Luckily, I already have Ghost, so I wasn't too worried about missing out on that one. But again, three solid pops. Glad I was able to pick these up, and definitely some solid finds out at the FLEA market. If you guys have any of these pops or any of the Call of Duty pops, let me know in the comment section down below which ones you have in your collection. And also, let me know which one of these three was your favorite pickup of the day. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss any future videos like this going forward. I'm almost at 1,000 subscribers, which is amazing. So I'm trying to, you know, hoping to keep that up. Again, I really appreciate everyone tuning in, commenting and everything on my YouTube and my Instagram. So really, this community has been great so far. But for now, this video is over. I plan on putting out more, but as always, thanks for watching.